achievements at such a young age are phenomenal and prove that anything is achievable. Thami Ngubeni is truly an iconic African woman in the making.
This is Johannesburg.
So we're all going to be big city doctors then.
South Africa.
Apart from your two wives, do you have any other sexual partners?
I would really say that acting is one of my great loves. With acting, I get to live many lives. I think that that's what appeals to me. I get to inhabit other people's bodies. I get to inhabit their mental space, and I get to inherit their history.
With her feet planted firmly on the ground and her spiritual beliefs deeply rooted, Thami Ngubeni is well on her way to the top and beyond. Juggling her multifaceted career as the editor of O Magazine, actress, radio talk show host, and community worker, she still finds time in her hectic schedule to connect with her creator.
The Thami Ngubeni story, where did it start? It started in Katlehong. That's where I was born, and that's a township in the East Rand. I was born at the hospital there, the Natal Spirit Hospital, and I spent my formative years there with my mom and my grandparents and my family. And then later we moved to Soweto, and I lived there, you know, for most of my teenage years and early teen years. My childhood was a very pleasant one. I've got very fond memories of being a child. My mom and I are extremely close. My mother is my rock. She is the one woman who has consistently believed in me in everything that I've ever wanted to do. And I think that I've really gotten from her, just to be sure and resolute about who you are and the person that you choose to be and the choices that you make. I've always known what appealed to me. I've always loved subjects like English at school. I've always loved drama. I've loved debating and public speaking. I loved history. And I remember whenever I got 100% for anything, I remember the high that comes from doing well. And it further fueled my love of literature and my love of writing and of the written word. When I finished high school, I wasn't really sure exactly what it is that I wanted to do. I went and I started studying beauty therapy, and that was awesome because I learned about various aspects of the beauty industry, whether it was for health and healing or it was the aesthetic part of beauty, such as makeup, the hair, etc. After beauty therapy, I started studying journalism as well, you know, through UNISA. I took some English courses and psychology and was working at a magazine called Tandi Magazine, which no longer exists. I was doing my internship there, and that's where I really fell in love with the magazine industry. It's funny how everything has come full circle in my career, in the sense that I never really practiced much as a beauty therapist, but never did I think that it would actually be something that comes into use now in my life as an editor. You know, when I look at the beauty pages or the fashion pages, or deciding, you know, if we're going to our health features, etc. You know, all of that informs the decisions that one makes.
From 60s party girl to Buddhist nun. It's so funny because I'm looking at this feature that I'm doing final checks on, and my passion in life has always been, you know, spirituality. That has always been the core of everything that I do. And so I find myself now in a position where I'm integrating all my skills and all my interests, from spirituality to beauty and fashion to lifestyle, to working with phenomenal women who've achieved amazing things, people who've gone through obstacles in their lives and have really managed to overcome that. And all of that just put together in one publication every single month. For me, it's such an immense blessing. This is an amazing team that I work with. It's actually mostly women, but there's a really good camaraderie within the team, a really great spirit. Everybody is efficient at their own areas of expertise and brings a lot to the table. I think that's what I think leadership is about. It's about helping people find the best in themselves and bring that out. There's nothing more powerful than when a group of like-minded individuals, especially like-minded women, come together
And I believe that that is exactly what we have here. My job entails putting together a fabulous magazine every month, but that also translates from the pages into meeting our readers and to meeting people who read the magazine. And so we have lots of tea parties that are sponsored, and we have all our readers dressing up in beautiful hats and just coming together and being in a very sacred space. Women just getting together to chat, to inspire each other, to find out about each other's stories and life experiences, and really fundamentally to have a good time.
After the break, we delve deeper into the life of this media chameleon.
While I was also doing my internship at Thami Magazine, I started working at Metro FM, doing news at that time, and also writing for the magazine. And then I eventually got into Teleschool, which was a kids program on SABC. And I was presenting for Teleschool and then ended up writing the scripts as well. So I really would say that my life has unfolded. One thing has led to the next without necessarily knowing which direction I was going. I decided that I really wanted to be able to empower myself and get into the film and television industry in greater detail and greater depth. I went to UCLA in California and studied film and television, did some extension courses there, and then decided to come back home.
This is Johannesburg.
So we're all going to be big city doctors then.
South Africa.
Apart from your two wives, do you have any other sexual partners?
I would really say that acting is one of my great loves. With acting, I get to live many lives. I think that that's what appeals to me. I get to inhabit other people's bodies. I get to inhabit their mental space, and I get to inherit their history. By taking on the roles and the life stories of the characters that I portray, I actually get to do that. So I feel like I live more through these characters.
I'm Inspector Stedman. You Nana?
Yeah.
Afrikaans or English?
Kwanga, take this closer, please.
So. And you're the assistant winemaker?
Yeah. I guess I'm what you'd call the affirmative action appointment.
It's just an amazing opportunity to work with the great talent that we have here in the country, and to further bring literature to life, to further bring stories to life. Thami, the producer, is interested in the kind of productions that add some sort of value to people's lives, that are really entertaining and fun, and there has to be a give back at the end of it. It allowed, I think, even the viewers to be able to see the ins and outs of getting into business. That was an amazing experience, working with Tokyo Sekgwale and working with the dynamic young talent that we have here in South Africa. You know, not only the ones who actually made it onto the show, but a whole lot of others that we saw who are probably 18 or 17 or 16, but they had these amazing entrepreneurial ideas that they wanted to pursue. And it really just gave me hope for our country, because I looked around and I thought, well, if this is the caliber of talent that we have, and this is the kind of passion that we have from our youth, then we really do have a great future in store and ahead of us.
Every generation brings with it a revolution of consciousness, a revolution of awareness, of thought and expression.
A large part of my work has to do with work in the fashion industry, whether it's presenting a show for young designers or different fashion shows that exist within the industry. And that really falls as part of my portfolio, where I would get invited to various functions to either MC or introduce a designer or talk about a various aspect of the industry. And that is also part of my passion. It just fuels me. I guess I'm a passionate person, passion all around. I really do believe that a healthy body does bring about a healthy mind. I love my sports. I've been playing sports since school. I play squash, I play tennis. It gives me the cardio that I need. You get to run around from one point to another. Helps with the coordination. I'm not always great at getting the ball the other side of the net. But, you know, it's something to strive for. I always, you know, want to make sure that I enjoy it. That's the most important thing. And even though you're playing against somebody who's the other side, it's a one-on-one relationship. So tennis for me is actually quite intimate in a way. Spirituality is something that we all have. I would define really spirituality as how we relate to, you know, our creator and how we relate to other people. For me, God is just my everything. You know, the cornerstone of my life, the cornerstone of every single achievement, the cornerstone of every single dream. And it's really great to know that there's a well that you can draw from when you are feeling depleted. You know, so there's no way that I can stand here and say that everything has been because of my hard work. I work hard, yes I do, but I'm also so blessed. And that I'm eternally grateful for, and I never want to forget that. I really do believe that the careers that we end up pursuing because of love are the careers that will allow ourselves to become more of who we already are. In awakening, in discovering life, in being here now. I have a show on Sunday mornings on Metro FM, and that show fuels me.
Rise to inspirational radio.
I play various types of music that will uplift the spirit, that will uplift the soul. There's Pastor Mwema, who is an amazing pastor, a great thinker, and a man of the word. We have guests almost every week. One time we had Deshaun Daisel as one of our guests, and Deshaun and I actually climbed Mount Kilimanjaro together.
What would you say have been the lessons that you might have learned, you know, the parallels between climbing mountains and climbing your own spiritual journey? Yeah.
She shared some amazing insights, like how the mountain humbles her, like how often people say they are conquering the mountain, but that is not the spirit with which you approach a mountain. The mountain allows you to climb it. So really we look at spirituality not from a religious point of view, but rather from an all-encompassing life point of view.
Thank you so much for sharing the sacred space with us this morning.
I get so many calls and so many emails from people who say they've been blessed by it and that they've really appreciated what they got on that Sunday morning. I feel like I've been in touch with people, that we've been communicating and in contact. So it's really a give and take, it's a relationship that we have. We're all learning together, we're all growing together. Climbing the mountain with Deshaun Daisel and the rest of the team was really awesome. It was one of the most humbling experiences of my life. I got to find out so much more about myself and also really learning to view other people and watch them as they went through their difficult moments of hardships and they went through their moments of triumph as well. When we reached the top, looking across the most amazing, amazing scene ever. It was just pure white, and there were clouds, and there was snow, the glaciers, and it was just probably the closest I've ever been to heaven. And for me, that's one thing that I'll always remember from that experience, the fact that one could continue going even when you felt like you couldn't anymore, when you wanted to stop and you willed yourself and you prayed yourself to keep going and your teammates were there spurring you on. That's the true value of the climb. It's the camaraderie that comes out of it. The one thing that I learned very early on in life, and it's also one thing that I learned from my mother, is that you need to be resolute about who you are, you know, and that has really served me well as a woman and as a black woman in this country. the truth for me was always just following my passion, always just following what felt right, always following what I thought I wanted to do. And that has, seems to have panned out. So I would say just follow your instinct, follow your gut, because there has to be something in there.